always been telling you guys that I am not here for fame. Neither am I here to become world most famous YouTuber. I'm not interested. What I'm interested in is the impact that I use my influence to make. I mean, starting my whole YouTube journey, I've always wanted to touch lives. I've always wanted to pull smiles on people's faces. But it was so difficult when I started, because I started with nothing. But with YouTube, I've been able to build a lot of businesses surrounding me. Okay. And I believe that it's time for me to fulfill one of my dreams. Do you understand?
Which is what?
Which is someday, I told myself, someday I'll use my YouTube platform to build a school, build a hospital, build clinics,
yeah,
even build houses for less privileged people. With the influence that I have, I really wanted to let my audience, even if I can't do it myself, let my audience, even if it's a dollar from each and everyone, mm-hmm, be able to do that, right? But I feel like being a leader, being in front of an army, you need to set an example for people to follow. That is why when I asked you, what is that one thing that you would love to change in your village, you said, you want to do what?
I would like to build a clinic for my people. So if I were to change anything, really, is access to health facilities, even if it's just a mobile clinic. I've been mobilizing a couple of people to get a mobile clinic. I haven't gotten much of a response, but hopefully that is really what I would want to get.
It is something that you really want to do?
Yes, that's something that I really want to do, because it's not only my village, the Angolan people also come for the clinic.
So we love to build a clinic for the people. So it's like 100,000 Namibian dollars, which is roughly 10,000 USD.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna take that upon myself. I'm gonna build the clinic. Is it a what kind of clinic you want to build?
So we would ideally would like a mobile clinic.
A mobile clinic.
But if it's not mobile, we can just have the building stationed where the health professionals can have a place. Because right now, when the health people come to my village, they stand under a tree. For immunization, people stand under a tree. There is no clinic or structure. So that would really, 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 really change things in my village.
I want to promise you, it's not like I'm just saying it. I want to let your village be the first ever village that I'm going to start my project. This is not something about somebody giving me money to do it. This is from my own pocket. I want to build the clinic that you're looking for. So you have to do this for me.
Okay.
Right now we're still on the way, like we're still traveling.
Yeah.
So when I get to Ghana, just let me know where to send the money. I'll send you the money. When I send you the money, please, maybe you can do a video and let me know that you got the money.
Okay.
Right? And is there any procedure we need to follow right now?
Yeah, I think that there will be a procedure that we need to follow. First, before you send the money, let me just find out from the government,
okay,
what are the requirements.
Okay.
Once we have gotten a go-ahead, because we already have the place, it's just right behind my house where the clinic will be built. Once all that is in order, then I'll contact you and then you can send the money and we can start the process.
So I'll be in Ghana,
okay,
waiting for you, and just update me on everything that is going to happen. And if the hospital is built, I'll still come back here just to show people that it's not just about talking, it's about actions. Because I want to see more Africans supporting Africans. I want to see more Africans taking it upon themselves to help other Africans. I cannot do everything, but I know I can do my part. You know, we are all changing the narratives of Africa, and I feel like we all have to play a part in doing this. So if you don't know, we're in Namibia in May, and I'm uploading this video in August. You know why? Because we wanted to have a permit to start this project, because this is one of the things that is dear to my heart, and I really, really want this village to be the first village that will benefit from what I want to do in Africa. And we've been waiting since May. So now we finally got a response yesterday, even though it took so long, but they still apologized to us. They said, "I sincerely apologize for taking so long to respond to your request. I had to collect information to enable me to give you the objective information." And the response that we got, it's not a good one, but I believe that I have a platform of which you can help me tag the Minister of Health to make this possible for us. So this is the response that I got from the Office of the Regional Director. It's addressed to John Hango. So I read. I'm not going to read everything, but I'm going to put it on the screen. This is number four. It says that the finding is that Ohawenga cannot be allowed a full swing clinic at this moment, as there is a clinic already planned at Ohenhono, in the same constituency. This implicated that the required distance between the health facilities, the clinics have serious staffing implications, and they are built as per the region plan. So they're saying that Ohenhono is already approved and it only needs funding. So let me know what you guys think, man, because I am doing this because of It's Woven. And I'm also doing this because of how that particular village accepted and embraced me and the entire crew, yeah? So them telling me that another village needs funding instead of us not allowing us to do, not allowing us to continue our project in the village that I want to do, it's something that I really don't understand. But if there's anything that anyone watching me can do to make this possible, feel free and reach out to me in this email below. And yeah, just let me know.
Sure.
And yeah, I'll make it happen.
Thank you so much. I feel like I have to say this. This was really, really unexpected. When we met up, I just thought it's purely for content creation. And yeah, we're going to create YouTube videos around my village, my lifestyle, which I'm very, very proud of. So I was happy to find another one of the biggest African YouTubers come over here and showcase what's happening here. But then to hear that you're going to build a clinic for my people, I've been reaching out to especially Namibians, and no one came on board. So this is really, really a major step for us, for our community, for my village, and we really, really appreciate it. We'll definitely keep you in the loop. We'll show you. I think the clinic will probably most definitely be named after you. The clinic will probably be named after you, but it would be good for you to come for the inauguration.
I would definitely come back here again. But I just want to say that you've been amazing. Thanks for hosting us. If I didn't listen to my people, I think it would have been one of my worst mistakes ever, because if I knew, I would have come earlier. You know, I'd have stayed more days, you know, because I think all my trips in here, I think this is the place that I had more fun, and it was just a short time. So I want to say thank you so much on behalf of the whole crew. Thank you so much, and thanks for the goats. Thanks for the good. But definitely I'm gonna come back again as another visitor, but I'll come with 10 people, which I think we deserve a cow.
Thank you. And yeah, the kids were happy to see something different. It's the first time seeing a drone. They kept telling us the story so they could see us while we're in the field. And that's really amazing.
Amazing.
Something different, it's motivating to them as well. So what you've done here, it's an impactful thing that will go beyond what you can possibly imagine, especially for my family and my community.
Thank you for everything. And I'll see you on YouTube.
Definitely.
And thank you so much for being part of this family. Don't forget to subscribe, please. It's very important to subscribe, like the video, and share to other people. And I want to say something. If you're an African, learn to help other Africans. Learn to support your fellow Africans. Learn to embrace an African as one of your own. And thanks to African Kings and Queens, you guys gave me this t-shirt, and I think I've been wearing this in almost all my videos, including the jacket. So I'm gonna put your numbers on the screen. If you're living in Namibia and if you wanna buy one of this, please do so and buy. Let's support this brother's business. And yeah, he lives in Walvis Bay, and I believe that he can do delivery in the entire country. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. I am Maya.